me, Jen. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome to a little quick video that I thought I'd film today because I've been wanting to film it for a little while now and I've just managed to figure it all out. So I'm gonna film it now. It's a little bit more chill. I'm on the ground with some of my Harry Potter stuff behind me. Not the cleanest of shelves, but it's there. I do have my beautiful set of Bloomsbury hardbacks. I think I'm gonna leave that like that and put Bellatrix there. So the video that I wanted to film today is a TBR video, as you can tell by the title. I have never really enjoyed setting TBRs for myself because I am a mood reader, as I've said in many of my videos, and I find that having a set TBR tends to deter me from wanting to read books. But I am very excited because this, like, July is the readathon month, which I have never taken a part of myself, and I've never done like a 24-hour readathon either, which is also something that I'm going to do. So the first chunk of this video is going to be dedicated to the medievalathon hosted by Holly Hart's Books, and then the very last little bit is the 24-hour readathon that I'm going to be taking a part of, which is on July 6th, which is hosted by Basically Brit. And then I was just probably going to mention the one book that I am doing for a book club with my friends and how that all ties in. So for the medievalathon hosted by Holly Hart's Books, as I said, there are different prompts that she's set up. I have them here in my book written all down, that you can fill during this readathon. So it goes all throughout July, which is really great because I have some really big books on my TBR that I want for this, that I want to tackle, and it's going to take me longer than just a few, like a week or something, to get through them. So what she has here is she's set up like a level of nobility type thing that you can aim for. So like if you read one book, you're gonna be a peasant. If you read two books, you can be a squire. Three, you can be a knight. Four, you can be a count or a countess. Five, you can be a prince or a princess. And six, you can be a king or a queen. Or six plus, you can be a king or queen. So I'm aiming to be a king or queen, I guess, because there is enough time in the month for me to get to all these books. We'll just have to see how busy this month becomes. So I'm going to go through the books that I've chosen and for what prompts that they're going to be for. I'm not going to cover all the prompts, but you guys can check out her video down below to see all of them, because she has weapons prompts and then like attire prompts, which is really cool. So very first thing, I'm going to cheat just a little and I'm going to use my read of A Clash of Kings for this prompt, because I know I'm not going to finish it before the start of July. There's no way. I'm not even halfway through it yet. There's no way I'll finish it now. So I'm going to use this one for the prompt that is a book where the character fights for the throne. Game of Thrones is a perfect prompt for that. So this is my very first one. This is my priority because I am already in it. So hopefully I can get this one done. I'm sure I can. I've been reading it pretty good, so. The second one I'm going to talk about, the second prompt, is a book with a dragon on the cover. And for this one, I've chosen, I have a little sticky notes to tell me which ones I've chosen for, is Aragorn. And I'm also going to buddy read this with my friend, because I mentioned I was reading it this month, and she's like, oh, I really want it, like, I really like those books. And I'm like, do you want to read it with me? And she's like, sure. So I've never read Aragorn, but I'm planning to get to it this month, which is exciting, and dragon on the cover fits very well. The next one I'm going to do is, the prompt was a shiny book, so that could either be like a shiny cover or a shiny text or something like that. So I went with Artemis Fowl because the name Artemis Fowl is shiny, and I picked this up at the thrift store just the other day, and I really want to get to it. I don't know why I'm so intrigued by it. It's middle grade, so it should be pretty easy to get through. And I heard of it as a kid, but I was never interested in it. I don't know why I'm interested in it now, but I want to read it, and it should be a fast read for this prompt with the shiny font. So that'll be fun. The next prompt is that I'm going to try and fill is read a thick paperback. Now, because I am getting through the Game of Thrones series this year, that's my goal, and I'm going to hopefully finish this within the first week of July, I'm going to pick this one up. Well, you can't even see it because the sticky note's on it, but A Storm of Swords. This book is over 1,000 pages long. So if that doesn't count for a thick paperback, I don't know what does. But yeah, this is going to be probably one of the ones that is going to take me the whole month to get through because it's so big, but I really want to try and get through it because I'm really liking my read of this series. I only reread the first book. Second book and third book are new to me. So that should be pretty good. The next one that I'm going to try and read is because I just want to get in all these books. I want to become a king or a queen. The prompt is a book that has yellowed over time. So I looked on all my shelves and most of my books that have yellowed over time are classics. And I know that those take me longer than normal books to read. So then I turned to my Harry Potter collection and this copy of A Sorcerer's Stone. So this is the American version. I'm Canadian, so Sorcerer's Stone. If I accidentally say Philosopher's Stone, sorry. But it is yellowed over time. I don't know. Here's a brand new book as comparison. It's not really showing up on camera, but it has yellowed over time. So I think I'm gonna do this. And I think in August I might do like a reread of the Harry Potter series, perhaps, or like a few of the books, because it's been a little while since I've read them. Like less than a year, which is a little while in my mind, because I love Harry Potter. But yes, this is the one that's going to fill that prompt, the yellowed pages prompt. I was gonna go like and twist the words and be like, yellowed, why don't I just use a yellow book and do that? But then I was like, but the pages aren't yellow. These pages are like brand new white, so couldn't do that. So the next two books actually fulfill different things than just this readathon. So because I'm also doing the Basically Brit readathon on the 6th of July, which is the 24-hour readathon, hers came with only one prompt, and it was to read a book that has been on your TBR or your shelves for years. Now, this is the oldest book on my TBR. It has been on my shelves since I was like 14 years old, and I am 21, turning 22 this year, and that is Graceling. So this is what I'm going to be reading for the Basically Brit 24-hour readathon, which I'm excited for. I hope I can get through at least most of it, if not all of it, in that day, in the Saturday. But this also counts for one of the medieval-a-thon prompts, and it's because there's something, a book with something pointy on the cover. There's a sword on this cover! So that counts for one of the weapon prompts that Holly has set up, which I'm very excited for. It also could count for the shiny book, because this is a really shiny paperback, but I'm gonna try and not overlap prompts, just so I can say I didn't have to. So I'm very excited about this because at the age of 14, I had made it to here in the book and I just never picked it up again. I had a habit of doing that. I would go back into my shelves and find bookmarks, like put in books in different places when I just like stopped reading the book. It doesn't mean I wasn't enjoying it. I really enjoyed this book. This is one of my favorite books that I was reading, and I just, life got in the way and I never picked it back up. So I'm picking it back up now. And the last one is the read that I'm doing with my friends as our like book club read. So this month, the month of June was the month where we had to read The Moonstone by Wilkie Collins, and that was my pick because I was the only one with a book picked for our book club. I was like, well, why don't we read The Moonstone by Wilkie Collins as our first read? And I'm almost done it. I have just under halfway to go, which should be fine. I was reading it right before this, so that's good, and I'm really intrigued by it. And most of my friends have either, I know one of my friends has finished it and the other one's very close to finishing it. I'm not sure where the third one is, but we're all enjoying it, which is nice. So the next pick, my friend Sarah picked it. It is Good Omens by Terry Pratchett and Neil Gaiman. The show just came out and I've been really intrigued to read this one because I heard it's absolutely hilarious, and I've heard the audiobook is really good, so I'm gonna listen to this month, coming up later, I guess. But I also picked a copy up because I like to annotate my books, especially for book clubs and stuff like that. So I'm going to read this one over audiobook, and I think I'm also going to read this one over audiobook, Aragon. And I do have the Harry Potter audiobook as well, so like I know I can get through them faster on audiobook than physically, but those are just options for this month. I also have a few other audiobooks that I want to read at, throughout the month that are like more lighthearted rom-com reads, which are weirdly some of my favorite things to listen to on audiobook. But anyways, so that is my TBR for July. Yes, it's a lot, but I'm very excited about it. And I hope that it doesn't completely consume me, and I hope I can get through them. I'm glad that I picked like three like more middle grade books, and then like one YA, and then like adult, and then high fantasy. Like I got a good mix. Yeah, I don't have any contemporary on this, but the contemporary didn't really fit the prompts all that much. I mean, I could have done like for red on the cover, I could have done one of those, but none of my contemporary that I want to read have read on the cover, really. I mean, the one, the Paper and Heart Society, if I really want to read it, I will, and I will count it for the red on the cover because of the thing. Oh, the Good Omens, by the way, is my red on the cover pick. Yes, I do realize it is entirely white, but I am being picky, and there is red text right at the bottom, and there's also red on the back, so there's red on the cover. I'm using it for this prompt. Anyways, so that is it for my video today. I really hope you enjoyed it. It's a little bit more chill. It's a little bit more, you know, just kind of chatty. And I enjoy these videos a lot. And I'm just kind of sitting on my ground. Oh, there's Pig, by the way. Pigwidgeon. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed watching. And I hope to see you in another video soon. Stay kind and keep on reading. Bye.